This morning, I woke up and I had sent dozens and dozens of emails with the same message to different people. Now, I did not want to send all of them in BCC and I did not want to use marketing, email marketing tool. I decided to automate this. So welcome RPA champions. In today's video, you are going to be saving so much time that you're going to be grateful to me for the rest of your life. We are going to be automating email marketing or sending emails with Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, a completely free tool available from Microsoft that is extremely easy to install. All you have to do is search for Microsoft Power Automate Desktop and you will find the tool online. We are going to automate an Excel file that has a list of different emails that we need to send. In this example, I am using the same email, but you would use different emails that you need to send. Let's say you are sending different birthday invitations or invitations for a wedding, or maybe you want to contact all of your customers regarding a specific order and you don't want to send every single one a specific email with the same text, but you would like to automate that process. Let's jump into Power Automate and see how this is done. We are going to build this process in 4 steps. This is step 1 and we're going to start by creating a new process from scratch. We're going to name our process with something meaningful so that we don't lose it amongst all of the other processes that we are going to be creating, because automation is going to help us save so much time. You will make hundreds of processes. Now with step 2, we are going to be extracting things from Excel. We have created a blank process and the first action that we have to do is to launch an Excel file. Now we're going to open the Excel file where we have our Excel information that we want to use inside of our process. Now let's select that file and we're going to be opening exactly that file. The next thing that we have to do is we have to find an action that is going to give us the ability to extract that information, and let's read from Excel worksheet. We're going to select also a range because that is the simplest and quickest way of selecting information from an Excel sheet where we already know the limit and where we already know the content of the Excel sheet. So let's say we have our emails in, we're going to start at column A and we're going to end in column B, and we're going to get all of the information from cell 1 all the way down to cell 37. And that's going to collect all of the information that we have inside of our Excel sheet. Now, this is going to be the variable that is going to be produced. We are going to rename it so that it's more meaningful and so that our process is easier to work with and manage later when it keeps on growing. Next thing, let's just close the Excel sheet because we don't need it anymore. We don't want to leave it open there so that it stays in memory. All right, with all of this done, now we have to do the web automation part. So sending the email, I'm not going to be sending it via web. I will be just sending it via an SMTP server. I will be using Gmail. So you need to get the SMTP information from your server. Before sending the email, however, let's create a loop. Now, what a loop is going to allow us is going to allow us to send this email. And I will configure the email in just a second. But for now, let's configure the loop. The loop is going to loop through all of the contacts that we are going to extract from the Excel sheet, and we are going to be using the current item. The current item is the item that is currently the one being processed inside of the loop. So when we send our email, we can refer to anything with the current item. Now let's set up our email. So let's configure our email, and before we do that, let's just set a default display message. And let's configure our email. Now, in our email, we are going to be using SMTP, as I said before. So we're gonna put the default SMTP configuration from Google. And you can do this with pretty much any provider of mail. So like this, we have inserted all the information that we need, and we have also inserted the variables.
And now for the final part of our process. We need to add this, and this variable to our process. These are the variables that we are extracting from the current item and are the rows in the Excel sheet. Now, once we have added that, we can add a wait for 2 seconds to make our process more stable, and we're finally ready to test our process. everything should be good and we can go to Microsoft and check out all of the emails that are being sent right now and being prepared by Microsoft Power Automate for us. And we can see the first email that has been sent. Here is another one that is being sent. All of them are using a custom message, a custom email, a custom content, and all of the parameters that we've set. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is how we can create a process that is going to send emails from an Excel sheet. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.